sometimes it comes across as if I got onto YouTube to save the world. I got onto YouTube to save myself. Rock and roll is about capturing a moment. It's an instinct. It's not something you would just sit out and write in the quiet of your study. I always wanted to be a rock star. When I got my first bass guitar at the age of 15, that was it for me. I didn't have a whole lot else going on in my life. We are very different people with diverse personalities. We are one, but we are definitely not the same.
I wanted to play in a rock band, and my dad stepped in with a school notice. It was him. It wasn't even my idea. I put up a now legendary notice up. I think the wording was like, "Drummer seeks musician to form band." I just thought of it as a group of people coming together to have a bit of fun, never anything else. No ideas, no expectations. I just left the band, but we didn't tell the band. He just told me. He was feeling at this point that he couldn't serve both God and man. I decided I couldn't either, so we both quit. Told throughout 1987, we were on the cover of Time magazine, got Album of the Year at the Grammys, a number one album and 2 number one singles in the US. It was a dizzying period. I was in a bit of trouble. At first, I thought it might have been the smokes, but I don't think it was just that. I think I damaged my voice.
Being at Holly's birth was such a profound experience, seeing a new life, your own flesh and blood entering the world. It was miraculous and terrifying all at the same time. I remember just hoping that Ashley and I were going to make great parents.
You become familiar with environments around death. When you work in Africa, a certain stench, a certain devastation, and the rubble of it. But in my own family, it was bringing me back, closing the circle, bringing me back to my mother's death. I thought I had escaped it, but I was wrong.
The definitive book for any YouTube fan is available now in hardcover at your local library.